Hi, hello, welcome back to our YouTube channel. This is Balakrishna. Okay, today I'm going to explain in this video class 10th chapter 11 trigonometry exercise 1.1. Okay, question number 5. If 3 tan A is equal to 4, then find sin A and cos A. So here given 3 tan A is equal to 4. So 3 tan A means 3 into tan A. 3 multiple going to side of divide. So tan A is equal to 4 by 3. So tan A means what? Tan ratio at angle A. So what the tan ratio? Opposite side at angle A to adjacent side at angle A. So that is a 4:3. So here opposite side tan A is equal 4:3. So tan ratio at angle A. Tan ratio means the ratio from opposite side to adjacent side. So tan ratio at angle A means opposite side at angle A and adjacent side at angle A. So opposite side at angle A is each this opposite side how many parts dividing? 4 parts. Each part how much dividing? We know that that is K. Next adjacent side at angle A is 3K. So they are hypotenuse side, you know that. So how you can find hypotenuse side? By using Pythagoras theorem. So we have A, B, C. Okay, opposite side is 4K, adjacent side is 3K. So how you can find? By using Pythagoras theorem. So here, by using Pythagoras theorem, so AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So AB, B is 3K whole square, BC 4K whole square. So here AC square is equal to 3K whole square, that is here 3 square K square, 4K whole square, that is 4K K square. 3 square 9K square, 4 square 16 K square. So 9k square plus 16k square, how much? 25k square. AC square is equal to 25k square. Square moving to right side will happen, square root. AC is equal to square root of 25k square. So 25 how you can write? 5 square k square. So that is a square root of 5k whole square. So square root cancel, that is 5k. AC is equal to 5k. So here what asking that sin A and cos A? Sin A, that is sine ratio at angle A, that is your opposite side at angle A by hypotenuse side. So opposite side is what? 4k. Hypotenuse AC, that is how much? 5k. So here k cancel, that is how much? 4 by 5. Next, what asking that? Cos A. So cos A is adjacent side at angle A, hypotenuse side. So adjacent side is 3k, hypotenuse 5k. KK cancel, that is how much? 3 by 5. So sin A is 4 by 5, cos A is 3 by 5. Next, 6th one. In triangle ABC and triangle XYZ, if angle A and angle X are acute angles, such that cos A is equal to cos X, then prove that angle A is equal to angle X. So here, take triangle ABC, next triangle XYZ. So angle A and angle X are angle A and angle X are acute angle. Okay, such that cos A is equal to cos X. Cos A means cos ratio at angle A. Cos X means cos ratio at angle X. So then prove that angle A is equal to angle X. So here given triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. So cos A is equal cos X. Cos A, cos ratio at angle A. Cos X, cos ratio at angle X. So what the cos ratio? The ratio from adjacent side to at angle A to hypotenuse side. So cos A, adjacent side AB, hypotenuse AC. So that is AB by AC. Cos X, adjacent side XY, hypotenuse XZ. So here these two ratios are equal. How much the ratio are equal? We don't know that. Let us take that is AB. So AB by AC is equal to XY by XZ is equal to K. AC divide, going to rest of multiple. AB is equal to AC. XY is equal to KXZ. Okay, so here the ratio AB by AC is equal to XY by XZ. From this ratio we can write as XY here multiple, come to right side of divide. So AB by XY is equal to next AC by XZ. So when observe these two ratios, so here AB by XY, AC by XZ. But we don't know that this side ratio. So how you can find? By using Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle ABC, when the three sides ratios are, here two sides ratios are equal. The two triangle, the two sides ratios are equal. But you don't know that third side. So how we can find the third side ratio? By using Pythagoras theorem. So when the three ratios are equal, then the two triangles are similar. When the two triangles are similar, then the corresponding angles are equal. So in triangle ABC, by using Pythagoras theorem, so AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So here what you want? BC length plus AB, come to the right side, what happen? Minus. So AC square minus AB square is equal to BC square. So the place of AB you can take as KAC. So AC square minus KAC whole square is equal to BC square. So AC square minus K square, AC square, BC square. So in this two what the common? AC square. So AC square is taking outside, what the remaining? 1 minus K square, BC square. Square come to left side and square root. So square root of AC square of 1 minus K square is equal to BC. So square root of AB, square root A into square root B. So square root of AC square, square root 1 minus K square is equal to BC. Square square root cancel. AC into square root of 1 minus K square is equal to BC. So it is equation 1. So the length of BC is how much? AC into square root of 1 minus K square. Next, find that YZ. So YZ, how we can find? In a triangle XYZ. Triangle XYZ by using Pythagoras theorem. So hypotenuse side square is equal side square plus side square. So here you want YZ length plus XY, come to right side open, minus. So here XY is equal KXZ. So XZ whole square, square KXZ whole square is equal to YZ square. So XZ square K square XZ square is equal to YZ square. So XZ square you can add as 1 into. So in this two what the common? XZ square, taking outside what the remaining? 1 minus K square is equal to YZ square. Okay, this square come to left side of one square root. So square root of XZ square 1 minus K square is equal to YZ. So square root of AB, square root A into square root B. So square root XZ square, square root 1 minus A square is equal to YZ. Square square root cancel. That is XZ square root 1 minus K square is equal to YZ. So it is equation 2. So now we can do that. Divide equation 1 and equation 2. So here 1 by 2. So that is here 1 is BC, 2 is yz. So BC length is AC square root of 1 minus A square. YZ length is XZ 1 minus square root of 1 minus K square. So what the common multiple? 1 minus K square. Square root of 1 minus K square. Square root of 1 minus K square. Okay. So yeah, BC by YZ is equal AC by XZ is equal AB by XY. So the ratio of the corresponding sides are equal. So therefore, the triangle ABC is similar with triangle XYZ. When they are similar, then corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. When the corresponding angles are equal, then angle A is equal to angle X. Therefore, hence prove. So how we can prove that two triangles are similar? How that two triangles are similar? By using side similarity criterion. These two triangles are similar. How you can prove the side ratios similar to rule? By using the Pythagoras theorem. Thank you for watching my videos.